The Microsoft Dynamics 365 Business Central connector can send and retrieve data between BPA Platform and your Dynamics 365 Business Central installation. This allows for data to be synchronized between Dynamics 365 Business Central and third-party systems that it does not normally connect with. Whether Dynamics 365 Business Central has been deployed in the cloud or on-premise, you can choose to locate the agent on any machine accessible by the BPA Platform server or on the server itself. All communication uses XML, and the connector can be used to map BPA Platform data to Dynamics 365 Business Central objects and operations. XML responses received back from the Dynamics 365 Business Central API can be saved and used by other BPA Platform tools for further processing. All objects available from the Dynamics 365 Business Central API are supported, including code units, pages, and queries. In BPA Platform, under System, Tools, Data Connectors, let's double-click to open the connector configuration. The global configuration is used to create connections to the Dynamics 365 Business Central agent. When a connection is created, the available objects and fields of your Dynamics 365 Business Central installation are retrieved. Let's click Add to create a connection. And in the General node, type a unique connection name. Enabling Update Objects and Operations allows the schema in BPA Platform to be refreshed when an update is made in the API itself, such as when upgrading to a new version of Dynamics 365. In this instance, we will leave this option unchecked. The General node determines which agent this global connection is for. The Agent Connection node contains a brief summary of the connection. In the General node, you can enter the IP address or host name of the machine where the Dynamics 365 Business Central agent is installed. In this instance, as it's on the same machine as BPA Platform, we can enable Use Localhost. In the Advanced node, you can set the custom port number, and it allows you to set the protocol to HTTPS if you require. In this instance, we don't require these options. We can use Test Connection to ensure the connector can communicate to the agent successfully. The Business Central Connection node provides a brief summary of the configured connection. The Deployment Type node determines the connection for either cloud or on-premise deployments. This time we will select cloud. This node provides a brief summary of the configured connection. In the General node, you can choose to create separate environments, for example, for production or live purposes. To connect to such an environment, select Specify Environment and enter the environment name in the box. For this demonstration, we are connecting to our sandbox demo environment. Connection URL shows the URL the agent uses to connect to this environment and API. Then click Authorize and enter your Microsoft credentials. Use Test Connection to ensure the connector can communicate to the agent successfully. Logout disconnects the agent from the API. Use the Select Company node to choose the Dynamics 365 Business Central database this agent is specifically monitoring, and click Apply. If your Dynamics 365 Business Central agent is installed on a machine hosting more than one company database, you must create a separate global connection for each database you want tasks to access. And to end, let's click OK. We will now look at creating an on-premise connection. Click Add and give it a name. In Agent Connection, you can see a brief summary of the connection. In the General node, in the Connection Agent Server, you can enter the IP address or host name of the machine where the Dynamics 365 Business Central agent is installed. In this instance, as it's on the same machine as BPA Platform, we can enable Use Localhost. In the Advanced node, you can set a custom port number, and it allows you to set the protocol to HTTPS if you require. In this instance, we don't require these options. Let's use Test Connection to ensure the connector can communicate to the agent successfully. The Business Central Connection node provides a brief summary of the configured connection. On the Deployment Type node, we will set the connection as on-premise. The On-premise Connection node gives a brief summary of the connection. And on the On-premise General node, we can provide the host name or IP address of the machine hosting the Dynamics 365 Business Central client. In this instance, we are using localhost. In server instance, enter your organization's configured name for this instance. In the advanced node, you can set a custom port number, and it allows you to set the protocol to HTTPS if you require. In this instance, we don't require these options. The URL to the Dynamics 365 Business Central on-premise API is automatically built from the configuration we have entered. You must provide the username and password allocated to the Dynamics 365 Business Central agent. They must allow full access to the company database. Domain credentials can be used if required. Use Test Connection to ensure the agent can connect to the database successfully. Use the Select Company node to choose the Dynamics 365 Business Central database this agent is specifically monitoring, and click Apply. If your Dynamics 365 Business Central agent is installed on a machine hosting more than one company database, you must create a separate global connection for each database you want tasks to access. Then click OK to complete this configuration, and OK again to close the dialog box. Let's open our example task. Here we have a database query and convert XML to record set step. If you wish to map BPA Platform record sets, you will need a convert record set to XML or transform data step, as the connector requires XML as an input. Let's click and drag the connector from the task browser into the design area and provide a meaningful name for this step. The General tab is where you can choose the BPA Platform data source to be mapped to the Dynamics 365 Business Central objects. The data source must be in XML form. The data source can be no data source, which will require BPA Platform variables in place of the XML or record set objects fields. A task step, this can be set to an available BPA Platform XML data source. In this example, we will select output XML from convert record set to XML. Or you can define the schema of the XML that is used as the input data source for this step. The Microsoft Dynamics 365 Business Central Connector tool uses the industry standard XSD format. This can be imported or copy and pasted into the configuration box. For input source variable, you can specify the BPA Platform variable that contains the XML data at runtime. In the Connection tab, you can specify the connection you have previously configured. You can also use a BPA Platform variable or formula to create a dynamic connection. See the documentation for more information on this. In the Mapping tab, we can define links between the data source XML and those required by Dynamics 365 Business Central. The object dropdown shows the Dynamics 365 Business Central objects, and the operations dropdown shows the operations available for the selected object. In this example, we will use a customer object, and in operation, select add. We will now expand the trees. Here, the tree structure shows the data source fields that are available for mapping. On the right-hand XML tree, you can see the input fields for the selected object and operation. Mappings are created by dragging and dropping a data source field onto its corresponding Business Central connector input field. Only linked fields are used in the output XML. BPA platform formulas and variables can be included in the source data even when using a task step or custom schema. Drag them from the BPA platform browser to the data source's XML. These can then be linked to the relevant input fields. Each operation has an additional field, supplementary reference, which allows for traceability when transferring data from one place to another. You can choose to map any field to supplementary reference to assist with checking where the data originated from or at what time the data transfer occurred. We will map date modified to supplementary reference. And we will now map the other fields that we require. The Advanced Translations tab shows the XSLT generated for the links that are created. Use Enable Free Type mode to directly edit the XSLT. If new fields, objects, and operations have been added to your Dynamics 365 Business Central instance after this task step was originally created, use Schema Refresh to make the latest API metadata available for use. When using search operations, you can make use of filters to limit the data involved. You add filter conditions by right-clicking the output XML field and selecting Set as Filter. If your Dynamics 365 Business Central installation makes use of web services, the code units, pages, and queries are also displayed in the Objects dropdown in the Mapping tab and are shown with Service after the object name. The Options tab allows you to define how errors in this step are handled at task runtime. If the step is aborted, you can choose to continue processing onto the next step in the task, or terminate the whole task immediately. Click OK to close this step, and we will link the steps. And that's it for this BPA Platform Tool Overview video. Call us for further information or visit codelessplatforms.com. Thanks for watching.